What's going on, people? Welcome back to Slash Football. My name is Hugh Izzy.
And I'm called, what's my name again? True Geordie.
And we are here today to bring you all the drama from the last 5 minutes of the Premier League, especially if you think you realise or you can predict who is going to score and how many goals there are going to be in the last 5 minutes of this Premier League drama. Make sure you leave a comment down below and you could win yourself a ticket to a Premier League game of your choice. Is that exciting or not, Geordie?
I'm quite excited about that, actually. I get excited about a lot of things, mainly women, but football as well. And I'm looking forward to that and I hope one of you wins it.
It's a pretty good prize.
It is.
We have got a goal already going in left, right and centre. Leroy Fer has scored for Swansea to bring them back into the game. They're 2-1 down at Leicester, the King Power Stadium. A little bit nervous right now, is there?
We've got a fantastic live band with us as well.
We have as well. We've got some fans in the buildings.
All right, enough.
Say hello to the fans. Just we've got one from Liverpool, one from Arsenal, and one from Chelsea.
You've had your fun, right?
But yeah, Leroy Fer, fantastic header. He's brought Swansea back into the game. Can they get another one late on? We really want that drama. And if you think you can predict how many goals they're going to be in the last 5 minutes, make sure you leave a comment in the description box below to win yourself that prize. Let's have a look at the scores up and down the country, though.
All right.
Everton are 1-0 up against Stoke currently. Chelsea 2-0 up against Burnley. Crystal Palace and Alan Pardew, my friend.
They're losing.
Are 1-0 down to Bournemouth.
Of course they're losing, mate.
You're loving
they're
that, aren't you?
Whenever they play, they seem to lose these days. Doesn't matter. 32 million on Benteke, mate. What's that doing for you? Not when you might score in the last 5 minutes, but right now, nothing.
No comment. Any kind of dig he can get in on Pardew, he really will. Yeah. So that's to be expected. Leicester still 2-1 up against Swansea City. Southampton, shockingly, are 1-0 down to your second favourite team, Sunderland. Jermaine Defoe with an 80th minute penalty.
What? Oh, they've scored!
Oh, wow! Drama! What do you know? Incredible scenes! And Sunderland,
you're blown. Down the bottom, you scum! Right!
Yes.
Bloody means Christ! Yes! That's it.
What did I say? He's going to be over the moon when anything bad happens to Sunderland or Pardew. That's a fantastic effort. A 20-yard goal there. A screamer. I'm not exactly sure who scored it. Who is it? Rodrigo, you absolute legend. He's brought Southampton back into the game. Still time for them to get a winner. Will they be able to pull that one
out
of the bag?
Hopefully a winner.
Now, earlier in the day, we had Craig Mitch.
Who?
He was at Tottenham.
Who? Yeah,
Craigie boy. You know, Mr. Patch.
Oh, the one with the patchwork beard.
Patch Adams was at the Tottenham Liverpool game today. He's going to give us a rundown of how it went.
It's Craig Mitch right here. I'm at White Hart Lane. Spurs versus Liverpool. Klopp versus Poch. True Hugh, the atmosphere is building. I think this match is going to be incredible. So let's see what the result is.
Players are coming out now. This is it. They're lining up. Let's see who wins, boys. Let's see who wins.
Mellon's giving a penalty away, Milner's stepping up, can Vaughan be the hero still? 1-0 Liverpool, Vaughan went the wrong way, Milner scores.
Who's on top of Liverpool, man? And it's on the 42nd minute, right before half-time, so we've got to try and get back into the second half.
So it's currently half-time, we're losing 1-0 to Liverpool. I really thought we was going to beat them today. Obviously, there's another 45 minutes, so there's still a chance to bring it back, but we have such a shocking record against Liverpool. And to be honest, we haven't got goals going this season. But I'm hoping, you know, the second half we'll get back in this. But as it stands, 1-0 Milner with the penalty. Let's see what happens second half.
Danny Rose! Danny Rose is put in there. Danny Rose has put us back in the game. And it's 19 minutes on the clock. Come on!
All right, guys, so that's it. Full-time right here at White Hart Lane. It ended 1-1. There was a penalty in the first half. Milner scored it. Second half, I believe it was the 72nd minute. Danny Rose with a great goal. Unfortunately, Spurs, we couldn't go and get the win, but still, I think 1-1 was deserved in the end. Back to you guys in the studio, Hugh and True.
Tottenham Hotspur against Liverpool. A faltering start for Tottenham and Liverpool. They got off to a great start, Liverpool especially, with thrashing Arsenal, really. And then they've lost to Burnley.
That's one of those things where Liverpool are inconsistent. I mean, they'll beat Barcelona, beat Arsenal, then lose to Burnley. Spurs, on the other hand, you know, Harry Kane still hasn't quite started the way he did last season. And I think until that happens, we're going to see more of the same.
Has he actually got any kind of link-up with Janssen? I've not been very impressed with the new
guy. I haven't seen much of that lately. I think they need to concentrate on getting him further forward. Right now, Kane's sitting deeper. Mm. I want to see him push further forward. For me, I want Kane as a number 9.
He's not a number 10. I cannot stand it when they put strikers as a number 10. Anyhow, I would actually like to quickly touch on the fact that Arsenal Football Club are 3-1 up right now. Great. And looking like we're getting our first 3 points of the season.
He's back.
To rub it in to Craig there. Not a great start for Arsenal either, though. However, it looks like we've signed a couple of players.
Yeah. What are you thinking about that, mate, so far?
I'm thinking Mustafi looks quality.
Yeah.
The jury's out on Perez. Mm. However, Chelsea have just gone 3-0 up. They've scored another one. And they have made a fantastic start to the Premier League under Conte, with Kante. Let's go over and have a look and see what our fans are thinking about that.
9 points out of 9, quality start from everyone. Conte, title challenge.
Title challenge?
Title challenge, three games in. Don't get ahead of yourself, lads.
Plenty big balls out here. He's giving it the big licks.
You know what I mean?
Really?
Unreal.
To be fair, Kante, probably right.
They look good.
Yeah, Kante. Yeah. Diego Costa's firing again. If you're going to mount a title challenge, you need a goal scorer. He's there.
They've got Michy partnering him now, and he looks lively as a bunny. I mean,
I think they want him to be the next Drogba, and he has actually quite a similar game to him. So
a lot quicker as well, a lot better with his feet, I reckon. They've got a good one there. However, I think they're in the market for a centre-back as well, which really would push them on for a title challenge. Have a quick look and see what the Newcastle United score is. They haven't started yet. It doesn't start for an hour and a half.
I'm looking forward to that, mate.
I bet you are.
I'm confident. I can be confident because I know I'm not going to have to face the music right now.
So both strikers out.
Yeah, Mitrovic
could be difficult against Brighton.
Little
made
punch
a good start
to the head. Someone give me a long Conor McGregor slap, and then Gale had the same thing. Unfortunately, now our two best strikers concussed. And that means they can't play in this game. And Brighton are flying at the moment. So I shouldn't really be confident, but you know.
Later on today, of course, we've got Manchester United. Jose Mourinho looking to continue the fine start that he's made to the Premier League campaign with a win perhaps against Hull City, who are flying right now.
It's going to come to an end sooner or later.
You think that's it?
Yeah, I mean, they're not Leicester. They're not doing a Leicester. Let's say it right now. Man United have got to win this one. It should be an open and shut case, Paul.
I'm looking for another Zlatan goal for my fantasy Premier League team. Will Paul Pogba hit the ground running today?
I didn't do me my fantasy team again, you know.
Are you kidding? The second week in a row. Mate, I'm leaving you behind.
I've gone, mate.
He's left for dead in the dust.
I hope I had really good players in at the start.
Let's quickly go back over the scores again. Chelsea 3-0 up against Burnley. Crystal Palace still losing 1-0 to Bournemouth at home. Everton 1-0 up against Stoke City. Leicester, the champions, finally 2-1 up against Swansea City. Southampton still 1-1 with Sunderland. And Watford struggling against the mighty Arsenal.
What will it mean for Palace? Three losses in a row.
What will it mean? It's a party at the Geordie House. That's what's going on.
I've been saying all along, the chickens are going to come home to roost, Farland Podge.
And
I'm
really
getting proof,
like,
right, as I really thought I would do. But, you know, it's actually getting really bad now, though, isn't it? I mean, if Benteke doesn't start scoring for them, that's it for them. Like, they're on a relegation battle at the very best.
He's got to pull some magic out of the bag because it really didn't work at Liverpool. But then they didn't play to him. I'm thinking if he gets a service there and they do like the crossing, it could be the one for
him. They were talking to getting rid of Zaha. Spurs.
Yes, Tottenham looking at £15 million deal. Do you reckon he's worth 15 mil?
Do you know what it is? The Palace chairman was insulted by that and actually said he's better than Bolasie. And if Bolasie's £30 million player, you should be offering more for him. And he's English, isn't he?
Controversial stuff there. Not really sure which side of the fence I sit on that one. However, drama is going on up and down the country. There are goals going in. If you've made the right prediction, don't forget, you're going to win yourself a ticket to a Premier League game of your choice. It's not too late to do that. Quickly do it before anyone notices that you haven't already.
All the games
are now in the 90th minute. The drama is about to happen.
Watford have just scored.
Are you kidding me?
No, I am kidding you.
Oh, wow. He had me there. He actually had me.
Did you see the fear? He's sweating straight away. Yeah.
Listen, we are a liability right now.
Yeah, you are, mate.
However, it looks like 3 points are in a bag. Very happy with that. Chelsea are going to be absolutely over the moon about the fact that Victor Moses has finally scored. He's getting a second life under Conte. He was fantastic for West Ham when given the opportunity last season for me. I think he's an actually really talented winger.
I would have had him last season for Newcastle, but obviously...
You would have had anyone, though. You needed all the help you could get.
I'd still have anyone right now, mate. That hasn't actually changed. But yeah, he's doing really well. He's an athlete.
I think he's
an absolute beast, isn't he?
And, Technically, very good as well.
Another team who've won, by the looks of it, Leicester City.
Indeed, Leicester City, the champions of the Premier League, are really clinging on, though. against Swansea City, and they haven't made the best start to this season.
Well, they lost the first one, nightmare, then they drew against Hughes, which pretty similar start to Hughes lot, actually. So
indeed, however, they were playing an extremely understrength Arsenal side with no defenders and no striker, so we won't talk about that either. Let's move on swiftly. there have been three goals so far in the last 5 minutes, so if you've made that prediction, you're bang on right now.
I went for five.
However,
I went for five.
He went for five. I think I went for three. We're in.
Come on. No.
We're in.
Not yet.
I'm going to. Palace have equalised. Incredible scenes here. And Alan Pardew is biting back. He's been listening to the last five on Slash Football via Facebook. It turns.
Have they really?
I think it's actually been disallowed.
Has it been disallowed?
We haven't had that one confirmed yet. Bit of drama, but there's a full-time whistle gone at Southampton and St Mary's.
I'm watching Charlie Nicholas right now on Sky Sports going, I'm sitting there thinking, it might not actually be a goal, Jeff. I'm sitting there thinking.
I don't think it is, mate. However, we've got a full-time at Chelsea. Stamford Bridges, 3-0 to Chelsea. It's and there's one. The confirmation of the equaliser that we needed. Crystal Palace have got their goal. Bournemouth. One apiece.
Oh, everyone.
It's a massive point for Pardew.
You got a point. The comeback's on. Bollocks.
Bitter or what?
We'll scrape the point at home to Bournemouth. All is forgiven, Alan. Sort your life out.
Arsenal fans, let's come over to you. I want a quick word about these new signings. I'd really like to know what you make of Perez and the new boy Mustafi, who look like they're on their way.
I think Mustafi is going to be very good and will make Arsenal do even better than
That's confidence, mate. That's the most confident not
something. I'm not going to lie.
Do you think
he's going to make us a little bit better? For £40 million, I want a little bit more than a little bit better. Because we're absolutely atrocious at the back right now.
He might be good.
He could be all right. We're not quite sure yet. However, we've sent our scouts for the last year, spent £40 million, and we're just going to work it out after a few games. Hopefully that's not the case and they know what the hell's going on. Arsenal Watford is a full-time result, lads, and we've got 3 points in the bag for the first time this season. Get in there, my son. Well played, Wenger, for finally putting your finger out as well.
Andrew and Jack are bloody loving it. Those not Arsenal fans, those Newcastle fans are celebrating like... Those Newcastle fans on the deck were loving that Arsenal win, I tell you.
Listen, mate, you're loving every single Arsenal defeat, so we need a point or two right now.
I was hoping, because this is your first sort of last five during an Arsenal game of the season.
We've got a full-time at Leicester. It's 2-1 there to Leicester. We've got a full-time at Southampton. It's a one apiece. We've nearly got a full-time at Crystal Palace. There's drama there, though.
We've got four goals.
It's now full-time at Palace. That's been officially confirmed. Pardew's got his point. And Geordie.
What's the point in Pardew? One at home to Bournemouth. There's
full times up and down the grounds. However, there's one match still going on right now. It's Everton 1, Stoke City 0.
One more goal for me to be right, by the way.
Koeman's made a fantastic start.
Oh, yes.
They look pretty decent.
Maybe Southampton were good all along because of him. Maybe. Something's funny? People laughing?
It's quite possible. However, I've really been impressed by the fact that, one, they've got new funding, new money, new management, a couple new players, and they've kept hold of their star
man. The Everton fans have been banging on for years, telling me what a big club they are. Maybe they'll finally actually show it now. Maybe Ross Barkley will stop being potential. Maybe they'll keep hold of Lukaku. Maybe everything's going to work out bloody rosy.
The shots being fired right now are unreal. However, a win for Arsenal, a win for Chelsea. They're both moving nicely.
That's it.
And with Alexis Sanchez, who played up top today, I want your thoughts in the comments section below. Whether you think Arsenal were going to play Perez up front, or is it Perez? I'm not sure which one he'll be happy
Probably
with.
Probably Giroud, mate.
Oh, please, come on.
Giroud.
Have we just bought a striker to play him on the wing? I'll be extremely disappointed if that's the case.
Speaking of Alan Pardew, that's exactly what they would do.
Pardew and Wenger have been seen out on notes together.
Wide right.
Oh, wow. Can you imagine? I actually kind of can see Perez playing on the wing.
Mate. It was fantastic.
We are full-time across the grounds. Let's wrap this one up now. Chelsea 3, Burnley 0, Crystal Palace 1, Bournemouth 1, Everton 1, Stoke City 0, Leicester City 2, Swansea 1, Southampton 1, Sunderland 1, and Watford 1. 3. Beautifully stuffed.
That'll
beautiful.
Be Sunderland and Palace fans going home delighted with a point, no doubt.
I mean,
fantastic.
Sunderland fans have travelled a long way for that point. Jermaine Defoe is a hero tonight because, I mean, he's a hero for me because he's in my fantasy team.
Oh, he would be, wouldn't he?
Because I actually do my team in the morning. Incredible.
Perfect.
Anyway, I hope you're enjoying the last 5 here on Slash Football. Make sure you stay subscribed, like the video on YouTube. If you're a fan, of course. And make sure you catch us on the next one. We're going to be back here every week at 4:40.
Really?
No, actually, we're not here next week. It's International Week. Oh. However, we're here the week after that, catching up on all the late drama with me, myself.
I need a break from him next week. Really.
And the true Geordie, my miserable friend here. And those fans over there who, thanks all for joining us.
It's been
an absolute pleasure. Maracas and all. It's been entertaining as anything. I hope you've won yourself a ticket to a Premier League game of your choice. But if you haven't, make sure you come next time and you'll be able to do
we'll probably give away more stuff, probably.
Yeah, we're going to send out...
We're going to start with some...
No.
There was a spider in here the other day.
Yeah, so it was.
It's time frightening.
It was frightening.
It is time to get
I'm thinking, what's coming out? However, we'll move on. We can send you things like stickers by snail mail if you're up for that. There's lots of things that we can do for you. Hopefully you're doing some for us as well. For now, though, my name's been Hugh Izzy. This has been The True Geordie. We are Slash Football.